this is the landing page for the CAS Formulations tool. This is available to any subscriber of SciFinder N, the SciFinder Discovery Platform. It is a standalone module, so you can access it through other means, or you can just bookmark formulas.cas.org. Now, we're going to start with searching for terminology that appears in formulations. This will be the basic search. As I mentioned, we're going to search on controlled release and then also a class of compounds, alkyl phenols. Keep in mind that we're going to do an advanced search as well. The advanced search is where you're going to be able to build a search with multiple facets that exactly match the criteria that you input. We'll see this live, of course. Ingredient search, if you wanted to see the regulatory information of a specific ingredient, that's what this flag will be for. We'll do that later. And then finally, we'll finish with create a formulation with the formulation designer. So to begin with, and we'll see auto text appear, we're going to look for controlled release. And as we see, we have auto text appearing. This is pre-querying the database and giving you ideas of different terminology that might be useful to your search. We're going to do a very broad search where we just input in the information that we're looking for, and we'll press the magnifying glass button. And now what we're going to find are formulations. And we will see these formulations, they have a title right here, where we're seeing hit highlighting of the search terms that we had. Location of that information, this particular formulation is coming from the claim text. And our analysts went through this claim set or any of the other publications that we see by hand. They went through these claims to make sure that they would give you an accurate representation of the targets, delivery routes, and physical forms that were reported by the authors of this paper, or in this particular instance, this patent publication. They also assemble components. We're going to see that if there are amounts reported, they will input that information and function. We'll actually see that there's a great deal more information that our analysts will pick up and make sure that you have access to those. And one thing I will point out is that our analysts have language skills at CAS. So they have scientific information, but they also have the ability to make sure that a publication that may not be in a language that you're familiar with is inputted in English so that you understand that in the claims of this Korean patent, for example, this formulation with these definitions has been reported. So this is one formulation. Anytime that you see a formulation, you can open that in a new tab. I'll just open that up and we can take a look at it later if we want to. The tabs will work independently of one another, so you can follow a path and then get back to exactly where you were just by returning to a tab. We'll just close that for right now. We'll see that substances are clickable entities as well. If you wanted more information about those substances, this is a preview of all of the details that we have under the ingredients detail. We'll get into ingredients in just one moment. But I want to talk about how we can start with this broad search like we have on controlled release and then narrow that down and get to something that's a little more manageable than the 350,000 formulations that we have found. And these are all going to be independent formulations. We cover specific industries, and we started with agrochemical, cosmetics, and personal care, and pharmaceuticals. We're currently adding content daily. So every day there is more content added to the Formulas tool, and we are starting to work into getting it into other areas of research. So these were the three that we started with, and we'll focus on those today, but you will notice that there's a lot more content, especially under the unclassified, such as things like coating materials and paints, as an example. Our analysts are picking up the purposes that are reported by the publishing authors. We'll see the top five most common purposes when we do a view all, and we'll see view all under physical form as well. We'll see that we have the top count all the way out to 100 alphanumeric, but you can also find. So if you were just looking for delivery, you could do a search on that and find all of the ways that delivery systems have been reported in this purpose filter. I'm just going to cancel out. I just want to show some features, and then we'll actually get into a little bit more searching. Physical form, if you wanted to have a tablet be the form that you are trying to produce, or you just want to see what your competitors are doing in the tablet sphere, and we can do a view all there. Specific delivery routes are reported once again by the authors, and our analysts are picking that information up. So you'll be able to understand if this is indeed a pharmaceutical injection versus some sort of a transdermal drug delivery system. And all of these terms that we're seeing in the filters are searchable entities. So if I wanted to search on delivery route, when I do an advanced search, I would be able to look for transdermal. Information included is one of the more useful filters that I often am engaging with. This allows you to see the formulations, in this particular instance, 304,000, that have the component amount reported. Now, these are transcribed directly from patent publications, but also journals. One nice thing is that if you were just interested in the formulations that came from a journal, if you had found that, you may not need to go purchase the article. You may have as much information as necessary to replicate what was done in an author's lab and skip the purchasing process. But we can also look into process experimental activities such as release rates. I think we're looking at controlled release over time, things like that, and then effective dose as well. As mentioned, we cover journals and patents, and you can focus your search into specific types of publications. So we could look at 66,000 formulations that come from journals, or we can specify, in this case, in patents, that I want to see claimed formulations, so the formulations that directly come from the claims. This can be very useful when it comes to doing, you know, some sort of an intellectual property search, where you're not so concerned about what's in the examples or figures or tables. You're just interested in what they actually claim from a freedom to operate standpoint. Product inserts as well. We get our drug product inserts from the FDA's Daily Med database. And this information is uploaded every Friday evening. So within every week, we are getting an update from that database. The other journals and patents that come into the Formulus database are being uploaded on a daily basis. So as soon as the analyst is finished with the analysis of the paper and getting those formulations put into the database, it's uploaded. So drug product inserts once a week. Everything else is generally entered as it's available. Organization. This is one that I really like to focus in on, because if you were doing a competitive search and you wanted to see what your competitors are doing within the controlled release area of formulating materials, we can do a view all here. And we'll see that we have some companies that appear different ways. This comes from either different journals or different assignee reporting by patent authorities. We can click on Unilever here. We could do a find and see if they had represented their name in another way, Unilever. And it will automatically truncate. So I can just search for Unilever, and we'll find all of those instances for Unilever, including ones where they're embedded. They might not be out in the front. This can be a very nice way to make sure that you're focusing your searching on specific ways that a company may represent their name because of the assignee regulations from a patent authority, or if you just want to make sure that you're capturing everything from a competitor, and you can go through the list here. And you'll notice that the Unilevers that I had selected on the first page are maintained here. So you can go from tab to tab and build your search and not have to worry so much about losing information as you might go and look in different ways. And we can add more competitors if we want to and create a search where we have updates on not just one competitor, but multiple competitors. I'm just going to cancel out once again. Also, publication year, if you'd like to see, you know, a specific date range, this once again can be very nice. If you're looking for patents, you might want to see only the last 20 years or so, and then you apply that. And this will automatically start at 2020. And then if you don't put an end, then it will go all the way to the present day. Okay, so the filters can be very useful. So let's go ahead and start using a few. And I'm going to go and take a look at process. I want to see the process that the formulators that reported these results used. And that's what we will see here. And we're going to see 205,000. We still see our controlled release. This is really nice. And I also want to focus in on examples, patent examples, because there tends to be a little bit more information there. So I will say, I want to see process information for controlled release that comes from the examples of patent publications. And what we see here is the first patent from US Patent Authority. And we get an overview here. But what I really want to do is I want to open this formulation up and get the complete picture of what was reported in this formulation. So I can open that in a new tab, and that gives me the freedom to come back to this search if I want to. So this is a record for a formulation. Reminder that they have to give a specific purpose, and that's what our analysts are picking up here. We'll see that we indeed are finding this from examples, and our analysts go through not just the examples, but also tabular information. They make sure to assemble those exactly how the intended as the authors intended. We will also get into the actual record for this entire publication, because as often is the case, multiple formulations can come from one paper. We are focusing on the formulation content and making sure that we find a formulation that exactly matches your needs. But if you wanted to see every formulation that appears in this paper, that's what you would find in this record. And we'll see that in just one moment. So as we go down, we'll see that we picked up more information than what was on that synopsis from the initial page. We'll see that we have controlled release, matrix polymers here, amounts reported, once again, transcribed directly from the patent publication. We pick up optionality. So if you're looking for mandatory substances or mutually exclusive alternatives, we also pick up things like one or more or at least one. And these are things that can be very useful if you're looking for comprising versus consisting of type terminology from a patent searching standpoint. Closed claim language and open claim language. We'll pick up the information for like flavoring materials and how much was added. But then as mentioned, when it comes to process, our analyst is going through and making sure that with respect to this formulation from the examples, from that table section, that this is the process that the formulators in this publication used. This is something that could be very useful to you. So as a nice feature, you may download this formulation with the process information and all of that ingredient information so that you might take this into the lab with you in a PDF form, print it off, or share it with another colleague. So as I mentioned, this is one formulation that we had selected from our original set, but maybe it would be nice to look at this entire publication and see what formulations were picked up in there. We can do this in a new tab if we would like to, but I'll just open this normally and point out that when you open the record for a publication that we have within Formulus, you will have access to a patent PDF. These are OCR'd, so you'll be able to do, control F type searching in your PDF viewer. We'll include abstracted information and also patent bibliographic information, including patent families. We assemble patent families under the simple family, so whatever the divisionals or the continuations or continuations in part, they'll often claim priority to a parent application. And that's how we assemble our patent families. We'll be able to see that we have access to PDFs for many of the different family members. But as I mentioned before, this patent could have multiple formulations. We saw one, but when we go in the formulations tab, we'll see that this patent publication actually contains six. So we'll see that this is the claimed form. These are the claimed formulations at the top. This is the way that we assembled them. We put the claimed formulations at the top. But as we go down, we'll see that there's a comparative example. We were in example two, if I'm not mistaken. There we are. And we'll actually see that formulation. So what can be nice is now you have access to all of the formulations. You can click into this, see that formulation that we saw before. And now when you hit previous and next, you will be seeing the formulations that come from this specific publication. You'll be able to navigate those quickly and easily and eventually get back to the claims. And once again, you can export each one of these so that you might be able to do a comparison of what was claimed versus what was from the examples.